In the Hume Zone segment tonight, our pal Brit has been closely following the developments in Wisconsin from Florida, and he joins us now from Boca Grande. Are you surprised, Brit, about how the left-wing media is reporting the story? We just pointed out a few of the most egregious distortions at the top of the program in the Tea Points. But, you know, don't they feel that people like me and other watchdog groups are going to call them on this reportage?
Well, a lot of members of the news media, you know, come from an era in which there were no other groups like Fox News that might present a different perspective. And I'm disappointed in what I've been seeing in a lot of the mainstream press, but I'm not surprised. This is pretty standard for these kinds of disputes. You know, much of the mainstream media, including AP dispatches I've seen, have said that the governor's trying to strip all the collective bargaining rights of these unionized government workers. That is not correct. He is trying to remove their right to bargain on fringe benefits and pensions, but as for salary, they would retain their right to bargain for salary, which is, you know, by many lights, the central issue. Obviously, these pension and other fringe benefits have come an extraordinary cost, particularly in recent years, and Wisconsin is one of many states that is suffering the budgetary consequences of that, and he's trying to reel it back.
But isn't he also putting limitations on what the union can get as far as salary by saying it's got to be, you know, indexed for inflation or this, that, and the other thing? I think that's in play, too. Look, there's no question, and the minutiae of whether Wisconsin gets its union givebacks or not really is not important to most other people in the country. It's what's going to happen after this, because every state in the union is watching this battle, and if Walker wins, then every union, in the heavily Democratic states, like here in California and New York, maybe Massachusetts, they won't do it. But many, many other states will do exactly the same thing.
You're right, Bill. A number of them are poised to do that. And let's remember, when we're trying to measure, you know, how this is likely to come out, that a couple of other Republican governors, Chris Christie in New Jersey and earlier Mitch Daniels in Indiana, have taken on some of these same issues and in some instances some of these same unions, or at least their counterparts in their states, and they have come out of it doing very well. It's particularly notable that Christie has done so well in what is generally considered a pretty blue state, New Jersey. He's become, you know, a tremendous hero on the right, and he remains highly popular in New Jersey. He's doing very well, and he has been very direct and very blunt and very aggressive about this, and so far successfully.
Now, if you look at the left-wing media coverage, particularly the New York Times this morning, they basically say, look, this is going to work against Republicans and conservatives, that workers are going to wise up and say, look, they're after our benefits. They, you know, in Wisconsin, they cut taxes back because they want to attract business. The only way you're going to get the unemployment rate down is to get more business to come in. The only way you're going to get more business to come in is to make taxes lower. But that's not the way the liberals spin it.
That's right. No, it isn't. And this is on these issues, when it comes to, you know, government workers' salaries, levels of taxation, particularly on private business and so on, journalists tend to line up with the Democrats and the liberals. That has been true for some time. You see it in the New York Times news coverage to some extent. You certainly see it on the editorial page, notably by the columnist Paul Krugman that you mentioned, and also by the show host on MSNBC, who apparently got her facts wrong. I think that some of these things that Paul Krugman is saying border on the hysterical. He's talking about
this
is union busting and this is defensive.
Look, if I were a liberal Democrat, I'd be hysterical, too, because this is this is disaster for the whole Democratic Party, because they build their power base on union labor, money from the unions, telling the working class Americans they're getting hosed by the rich. All of this is why President Obama is in such a big he's in a really tight spot. Look, President Obama comes out in favor of the unions in Wisconsin, and he has really not. We understand he's working behind the scenes, but he hasn't done it publicly. And he loses there? I mean, his power base just starts to crack. So this is huge for the Democratic Party and for the president.
Well, I think that's true, Bill. I also think that the connection between the Democratic Party and these public employee unions, which has been in many respects to the advantage of the Democrats. I mean, after all, you look at the biggest contributor to this last round of elections. It came from the Service Employees International Union. That's the union where Andy Stern was the president, and he was the number one visitor to the White House during the first 2 years of the Obama administration. So you get a sense of the pattern. But I think at this moment, these public employee unions and the large benefits that they have succeeded in winning for their members have become unpopular. They're in bad odor with the public, and the public is ready to see them challenged. And I think that these, that even in a state as blue as Wisconsin has been, the governor out there doing this, and the Republicans are holding the high cards. I don't think there's much doubt about it. And I'm not sure, Bill, that they will compromise on this issue. Remember, these kinds of public employee unions were opposed by liberals such as Franklin D. Roosevelt and Fiorella LaGuardia as being an undesirable thing, that you shouldn't have the kind of collective bargaining in the hands of people who work for governments.